It's always been more than a highlight show. It truly is a football night tradition. In now our 40th season, we bring you the best of Minnesota high school football.
TruStone Financial presents the KARE 11 Prep Sports Extra. Now, here's your host, Randy Shaver.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Prep Sports Extra. It's October. It's week six. Section football is right around the corner, and for many teams, it is go time. Is this going to be a year to remember, or one that just didn't pan out like you thought it would? Two teams fall into this category, Centennial and Anoka. Good enough to be 4-1 at this point of the season, but where does it go from here? Let's go to the Pumpkin Bowl. It's our spotlight game. For the Pumpkin Bowl, you've got to wear orange, and they were out in force tonight at Goodrich Field in Anoka. First quarter tonight, Zachary Welch for the Tornadoes. From 3 yards out, off the pitch, 7-0, Anoka in front. Centennial comes back. Nice run by Ty Burgoon. 23 yards on the cutback there. Almost took it to the house. Just tackled. The drive ends in a touchdown. Marcus Whiting, 22 yards out as he bowls his way in. Game tied at 7. Peyton Vodani, the quarterback. Watch the great footwork by Carson Benn on the catch. Wow. Later, and we're going to see it again, slow motion. He gets those feet, or at least 1 foot, inbounds. Great catch. Later in the drive, Podani's pass is tipped, and it's picked off in the end zone. Wow, Centennial, big play. Third quarter, 15-7 at this point. Maverick Harper, their star running back. 23 yards on the TD run, 21-7 Cougars. Later in the third, Daylon Cummings would sneak it home. Centennial up 28-7. Fourth quarter, comeback time. Podani to Trey Borchers. Great catch, 34 yards on this play for Anoka between two defenders. Podani launches one into the end zone. Will Quick. Looks a little like Tarkenton. Nice move there, but Will Quick makes the great knockdown of the pass, incomplete. Centennial then wraps it up. Harper, the touchdown run. The Cougars win tonight to go to 5-1. Big win over Anoka. Final score, 35-15. How about this? Lakeville South upset tonight by Rosemount, 22-21. Now last night, Eden Prairie drove the ball 92 yards on 22 plays, taking over 9 minutes off the clock to seal their win against Minnetonka. Short touchdown run by Dom Heim capped that drive. Eden Prairie remains undefeated. 28-14 was the win last night. Tackle Cancer Night at Maple Grove, the defending 6A champions hosting Coon Rapids. The Crimson feature the hottest running back maybe in the state right now, Chuck Lungama. Last week, the junior scored a school record 7 touchdowns and rushed for 328 yards.
It's pretty crazy. My freshman football coach, Coach Magstead, I never like really thought I'd be able to break his record. He always tells me, yeah, I got 6 touchdowns in one game. And on Monday at school, I went up to him. I was like, yeah, how do you feel about that? And like, yeah, it was pretty awesome.
Well, here he is tonight, getting ready to face Coon Rapids. We'll get to him in a minute. First, Caden Harney to Chuck Lungama. This is a receiving touchdown, and it's 7-0 Maple Grove. Dylan Vogel, 28 yards off the pitch, around the end, touchdown, 14-0 Maple Grove. Then Lungama goes to work. This is a 20-yard touchdown run as he takes it down the sideline, gets into the end zone, and then he comes back with this one from 46 yards out. He had 4 rushing touchdowns and a receiving touchdown. Now has 20 rushing touchdowns through 6 games. Matt Lombardi wins number 100 of his career, 55-6 Maple Grove.
Tackle Cancer is sponsored by Minnesota Oncology.
And to cap it all off, it was Tackle Cancer Night at Maple Grove. The Crimson have been one of the biggest contributors to TC since the Minnesota Football Coaches Association started all this back in 2012. Tackle Cancer hoping to raise $500,000 this fall to support cancer research and patient aid in Minnesota. An amazing night at Maple Grove. And a quick thanks to St. Agnes, who hosted their TC game last Saturday night when they beat Concordia Academy in the Battle of Dale Street. The Aggies raised a little over $1,500 for cancer research and patient aid in Minnesota. Tonight, they were in Austin, Minnesota. Landon Mickelson to Keegan Flood. Touchdown for St. Agnes. And a little bit later, Adam Hernandez would run one into the end zone. St. Agnes with a big road win to remain undefeated. Final score tonight in Austin was 42-7. Let's go to 4A now. Outside of the metro, we go to Princeton tonight, where the unbeaten Tigers, ranked number 6, hosted Chisago Lakes. Here we go. First possession of the game. That's Ryan Fay, the head coach at Princeton High School. And the new head coach at Chisago is Ryan Anderson. That team comes into the game 4-1. First possession, Eli Gibbs off the pitch. Touchdown, Princeton, 7-0. Second quarter, 14-0 Tigers, but the Wildcats, Carson Langevin gets in, and they're only down 14-7. But a poorly timed fumble late in the first half, recovered by the Tigers, led to Jonathan Kaiser getting a touchdown, his second of the game, and Princeton wins tonight over Chisago Lakes. They're now 6-0, 28-25. The number one team in 4A is Becker. It was 0-0 third quarter against Ricori. How about the catch by Mitchell Soltau for the touchdown? Wow, tipped into the end zone. Then Becker's Owen Angel. Watch him fly around the corner. He's going to take it to the house. 64 yards on the touchdown. The Becker Bulldogs are still unbeaten. Final tonight was 20-0. Totino Grace, Jaden Miller, the free safety against SMB. This is a pick six. 7-0 in favor of the Eagles. SMB trying to get something started on the ground. Steven Gustafson takes off on a 22-yard run here to move the chains, but it's not going to be enough because Totino Grace is locked in. Justin Kuharski, 94 yards on the touchdown run in the first quarter. Totino Grace wins tonight as we see him take it into the end zone. Final was 35-7. Why is that big? Because next Friday, they play Orono, who's undefeated. That's going to be our spotlight game. Totino Grace at Orono next Friday night. Let's go to 5A, Bloomington Stadium. Bloomington Stadium has been the home for both Jefferson and Kennedy for over 50 years. It's located at Old Lincoln High School, and it's seen better days. This is the last season of the games there. Next fall, both Kennedy and Jefferson we'll have new on-campus stadiums. Tonight, the Jags taking on Cooper. Touchdown run here by John Weber from 5 yards out. It's 27-7 Jags, but Cooper would rally and cut the lead to 27-20. On fourth down, Tyson Schultz hits Danny King for a little bit of cushion, and Jefferson with the upset over Cooper, 34-20 was the final. Tackle Cancer Night for 5th-ranked Sauk Rapids Rice in 5A. But here's something else that makes Sauk Rapids Rice special. They clean up nice. Here's proof. After every football game, home or away, the players go into the stands and they clean up. It's not just the football team either. It's basically all the teams at Sauk Rapids Rice.
And I don't think our kids feel like it's hard. You know, we're not asking anybody to do anything crazy. But after a game, just cleaning a little bit. Honestly, what's so cool is you just kind of see kids feel good. As corny and cliched as that sounds, like typically when kids are cleaning, it doesn't feel like work. They kind of think it's funny, them and their buddies going and grabbing a garbage bag and throwing away a couple water bottles. And then what's just so cool is when it's done, it's done. I hope that they're just learning that, you know, simple acts of kindness, like really not hard, not asking you to do massive things, but doing those kind of routine things routinely is just so highly appreciated.
Certainly is. Cool story. Sauk Rapids Rice wins to remain undefeated. They win tonight 24-12, and hopefully maybe what they're doing will become a trend around the state of Minnesota. Number one team in 5A is Chanhassen. Tonight on the road at Mankato East, Braden Winschittle to Cade Bush. Nice pitch and catch here. Winschittle would finish off the drive with a sneak touchdown. Chan wins tonight to remain unbeaten, 36-22 the final. Owatonna and Mankato West. Bart Makinich takes it in himself for the easy touchdown. Scarlets win big, 42-7. Hey, they play on real grass at St. Francis High School. Do you remember what real grass looks like? Well, this is what it looks like. St. Francis hosting Andover tonight. How about DeMario Davenport? Off the option pitch, see you later. Big touchdown run. Huskies in front at this point, 27-0. This is a crazy play here. Off the receiver's helmet, and St. Francis is going to get an interception. Watch the play here. I hope it's come. Here it is. Noah Lamson. Whoop, whoop. Pick off for St. Francis. Andover wins, however, tonight. We check the final, 43-0. Rogers wins over Elk River in a rivalry game, 31-14. St. Thomas Academy, big win over Apple Valley. Alex remains undefeated. And Brainerd knocked off St. Cloud Tech, and we'll be right back.
I'm Trent Page, defensive end at SMB, and you're watching the Prep Sports Extra.
Hon Highlights is sponsored by True Stone Financial.
A good neighbor would give you a cup of sugar if you asked. At True Stone Financial, we don't have any sugar, but we will give you up to $350 when you switch to a True Stone checking account. It's true, because we're True Stone.
Get ready every day with KARE 11 Sunrise.
Rise and shine, everyone.
Giving you an accurate forecast.
We're tracking showers moving in that could slow you down.
Breaking news from overnight.
Yeah, let's get right to the new video.
And you're noticing.
So good to meet you.
I cannot wake up without turning y'all on.
All together, you guys are kind of like a little family.
You guys are a breath of fresh air in the morning to start the day.
And that's my little routine, so thank y'all for making it better.
Every day starts with Sunrise on KARE 11.
Menards will help you stack up big savings when insulating your home. Plus, save 11% on all insulation. A properly insulated home can save you money on your utility bill, all while increasing your family's comfort. Plus, stack on the savings and save more money with additional federal tax credits on qualifying energy efficiency home improvement purchases. Pick up a roll of R15 high-performance craft paper-faced fiberglass insulation for just $14.99 after rebate.
Save big money at Menards.
This week's Hy-Vee hot deals are Hy-Vee Angus Reserve Boneless Chuck Roast, just $4.97 a pound. Buy two, get two free on select Pepsi products. And Campbell's Soup, just 99 cents, only at Hy-Vee.
Be a part of the Tackle Cancer campaign with the Minnesota Football Coaches Association. Raise money for cancer research and patient aid. Look for a Tackle Cancer game in your area this fall. Tackle Cancer, sponsored by Minnesota Oncology.
You do the most, so why not earn the most? With True Rate Checking from True Stone Financial, you get the most from your account. This much most, to be exact. It's true, because we're True Stone.
The KARE 11 Prep Sports Extra, sponsored by True Stone Financial. Hot Highlights is sponsored by True Stone Financial.
And we do have our Hot Highlights winner for this week, thanks to your voting all week on KARE11.com. 50% of the vote, Orono running back Liam Rogers with this crazy run. And let's check it out. Watch Rogers break a couple of tackles, kind of going backwards, right? And then watch him shake loose and find a seam, and away he goes. It's not a touchdown because of a great saving tackle, but it's an outstanding play. It's our Hot Highlights winner this week. We have three new choices to vote on Monday night at 6. Let's go to Class 3A. Will Hall covered a big game in Rockford tonight between the Rockets and Albany. Will?
Yeah, Randy, both Albany and Rockford entering tonight with 4-1 records. I tell you what, this might have been the highlight of the game. How about that mullet right there? The Rockets' defense was stellar tonight. Albany had the ball in the red zone multiple times in the first half, but Rockford's defense made big play after big play. Avery McDonald here coming up with the big fumble recovery to keep things scoreless. Rockford would strike first late in the first half. Tim Houghton with a 22-yard touchdown pass to Gophers preferred walk-on Harrison Bruhn. Rockford ends up taking this one in overtime, 20-14 the final. The Rockets move to 5-1 this season. They finish up the regular season with a pair of road games ahead.
I guess we're getting closer to hockey season, so the mullet is going to make its way back. Thank you, Will. Let's check out 6A Tackle Cancer Night at Edina. The Hornets hosting number 8 Shakopee tonight. John Warpinski, a 4-yard touchdown run to give the Hornets a 14-0 lead in the second quarter. Watch this run by Judah Forsberg for Shakopee. He's the quarterback, off the keep, finds the seam, and he's gone. 58 yards on the big touchdown run, barely gets into the end zone. Edina's defense does a nice job in this football game to hold on. Big interception right here, and the Hornets upset Shakopee tonight, 35-28. Wayzata hosting Prior Lake tonight. Hunter McGilvray takes this one 48 yards for the Prior Lake touchdown. The Lakers win tonight on the road at Wayzata, 21-17. Speaking of Prior Lake, Jade Abasiri is 6'6", 275, defensive end, strong, smart, committed to being the best. He was recruited by a bunch of Division I college football programs, but decided quickly to stay home.
I chose Minnesota because of the culture they have there. They hold people accountable, and you know, they have a certain standard, and they'll hold you accountable to that standard, and they'll help you to get there, develop you as a player, an athlete, and you know, as a person too.
Outstanding football player. The rest of 6A tonight, Lakeville North, 51-23. Stillwater, big win over White Bear, 38-14 the final. Blaine falls to Champlain Park, as we showed you earlier. Lakeville South upset by Rosemount tonight, 22-21 the final. Egan falls to Farmington, 56-28. Woodbury, big victory over Forest Lake. They're now 4-2 on the year. Buffalo now 5-1 with a victory over Burnsville, and St. Michael Albertville over Osseo. We'll be right back.
I'm Jade Abasiri, defensive lineman, Prior Lake High School, and you're watching the Prep Sports Extra.
You do the most. So why not earn the most? With True Rate Checking from TrueStone Financial, you get the most from your account. This much most, to be exact. It's true, because we're TrueStone.
The KARE 11 Weather Warn Day signals a change coming for your weather.
Big hail, downpours, and flooding over the last few hours.
Because severe storms strike fast, the Weather Warn symbol lets you know when to be prepared.
Today's Weather Warn Day certainly has been verified by what we're seeing on the radar right now.
Think of it as alert that keeps you and your family safe during difficult weather. So when the next storm is heading your way, you'll be prepared. Be warned before the storm with KARE 11 Weather Warn.
Be a part of the Tackle Cancer campaign with the Minnesota Football Coaches Association. Raise money for cancer research and patient aid. Look for a Tackle Cancer game in your area this fall. Tackle Cancer, sponsored by Minnesota Oncology.
This week's Hy-Vee hot deals are Hy-Vee Angus Reserve Boneless Chuck Roast, just $4.97 a pound. Buy two, get two free on select Pepsi products. And Campbell's Soup, just 99 cents, only at Hy-Vee.
Get 11% off everything now at Menards. Check out our lighting showroom and update your home with the latest trendy styles and finishes. Patriot Lighting provides a large selection of finishes and designs, so you're sure to find a style at a price that's right for you. With more than 140 stock lights priced under $50, the Torian Outdoor Wall Light is $11.97 after rebate. Visit our lighting showroom or check out all our lighting options on Menards.com.
Save big money at Menards.
A good neighbor would give you a cup of sugar if you asked. At TrueStone Financial, we don't have any sugar, but we will give you up to $350 when you switch to a TrueStone checking account. It's true, because we're TrueStone.
The KARE 11 Prep Sports Extra, sponsored by TrueStone Financial.
I think the passion that you bring is fun. You genuinely care about it. And I've told people that before. You know, when we won that first game against Eastview a couple years ago and I called you, you were genuinely very excited for us, right? Which I was so thankful.
My thanks to Nick Johnson. Back to the action. Let's go to 5A. Hastings at Armstrong tonight. When we got there, Armstrong was in control. Seth Newburn, 38-yard touchdown reception. It's all Falcons tonight. 42-7 was the final over Hastings. Monticello Park Center. This is a 32-yard pass from Kane Schlangen to Tyson Visnes. It would set up a few plays later. Schlangen, a one-yard keeper, and Monticello took the lead 7-3. Then on defense, Brock Holthaus with the interception and the big return for a touchdown. 55 yards on the play. Monticello wins a close one, 21-16 over Park Center. Matamidi wins over Creighton tonight. Touchdown run here for Alec Mahoney. It's going to cover a lot of yards all the way into the end zone. 34-18 was the final. Matamidi with a big win. Northfield and New Prague. Camden Kaiser fakes it, ends up taking it himself for the touchdown. Northfield wins tonight, 22-19 over New Prague. The rest of the North Star looks like this. Central beat Southwest, 31-14. Sauk Rapids Rice, we showed you that score, 24-12. They're now 6-0. Chaska wins tonight over Oconia. How about Irondale over Spring Lake Park, 36-27. JM over Century, 40-33. And Moorhead knocked off Sartell. At Breck tonight, Holy Family, Griffin Murray. Watch the interception for the Fire. He'll return at 30 yards. This is a big game for Holy Family. Dan O'Brien's taking over this program after leaving St. Thomas Academy. Tanner Davis, an 18-yard touchdown run. How about Holy Family? They win over Breck tonight. 34-0 was the final. The rest of the Skyway looks like this. Litchfield, big win over Watertown Mayor. Hutch over Wilmer, 36-7 was the final. Dassel gets back in the win column after losing to Litchfield last week, 35-10. Annandale still undefeated over Apollo, 34-0. North St. Paul falls to Simley, big win for Holy Angels over Benilde St. Margaret's. Other scores, we showed you the St. Agnes final, 42-7. North wins 59-0 over St. Anthony. Other scores, New London Spicer over Glencoe Silver Lake. Foley beat Spectrum, 46-0 was the final. St. Croix Lutheran falls to Concordia Academy, 24-14. Hill Murray over South St. Paul, 35-14. Pioneers, big win. Upset, Byron beaten tonight by Casson Manorville, 21-14. Winona, big win over Faribault, 12-8 was the final. Big Lake loses to Zimmerman, 18-12. Mound West Tonka rebounds from that loss to Orono last week and beats Delano, 42-28. Columbia Heights over Brooklyn Center, 18-6. And Fridley over De La Salle. We'll be right back.
I'm Zayshawn Rich, cornerback at North High, and you're watching the Prep Sports Extra.
You do the most, so why not earn the most? With True Rate Checking from TrueStone Financial, you get the most from your account. This much most, to be exact. It's true, because we're TrueStone.
Be a part of the Tackle Cancer campaign with the Minnesota Football Coaches Association. Raise money for cancer research and patient aid. Look for a Tackle Cancer game in your area this fall. Tackle Cancer, sponsored by Minnesota Oncology.
Lace up your sneakers and don't miss the Twin Cities Marathon. Be a part of the weekend with KARE 11 Plus. Stream every event from, well, wherever you want. Visit KARE11.com/marathon for more information.
Finish your exterior project in time for fall with Menards. Aluminum soffit is low maintenance and easy to install. Pre-finished panels are stocked in white, brown, and black, ready to take home today. All aluminum soffit is 11% off. Transform your home with a new garage door from Ideal Door. We have multiple styles of 9x7 and 16x7 size doors in stock today. Get a 9x7 garage door for $334.99 after 11% rebate.
Save big money at Menards.
A good neighbor would give you a cup of sugar if you asked. At TrueStone Financial, we don't have any sugar, but we will give you up to $350 when you switch to a TrueStone checking account. It's true, because we're TrueStone.
You know, the Twin Cities lucky to have prep sports beat writers who cover the teams and the games with great passion, regardless of the sport. Jim Paulson is one of those guys. He works for the Star Tribune, and we recently sat down and talked about his job and Minnesota high school football. You've been doing this a long time. Has it changed a lot over the years in how you cover high school in Minnesota?
What's changed a lot has been the immediacy, I think, of what you do. It used to be a time when I could go to a game, I could stand on the sidelines, I could walk back and forth, I could get my interviews, then come back to the office and write it after a game. Now the immediacy of what you need to have. You need to have live scoring, you need to have tweets, you need to have social media, you need to have game stories written just minutes after the game is done. And then sitting in my car, writing a game story on a 15 or 20 minute deadline after the game. That's the thing, the immediacy and the quick turnaround is the biggest change.
The glamour of media, right?
Yeah. People tell me, you must have a great job because you get to go to the game. Yeah. And I always say, well, the games are fun, but it's after the game. That's when that work happens.
Favorite stadium to cover a game?
Ettinger Field. It's on St. Paul. It's built in kind of a natural bowl behind the old school, high school there. They've got a tunnel that goes out to the practice field before the game. The kids sit in stands that are built into the turf there, into the bowl there. So I love Ettinger Field.
Most enjoyable football player you've ever interviewed and why?
I really like Will Sather, the center at Eden Prairie this year. He's one of the reasons Eden Prairie I've got ranked number one, but he's intelligent, he's gregarious, he's a great wrestler as well. He's going to Princeton. He's a very smart kid, very easy to talk to. He's one of my favorite kids to talk to. If I need a quote from Eden Prairie, I'll look at Will.
One of the things that I find fascinating is how you decided to take over the football rankings. And I appreciate that. For people who don't know, you took it upon yourself to kind of get this thing organized. Why do you think that's important? Why do you think football rankings for high school football is important?
I think rankings draw eyes. When the Associated Press decided they weren't going to do it anymore, I was kind of flabbergasting.
Exactly.
Because this is a chance for kids to get exposed and to get rewarded for excellence. And so I figured somebody needed to do it. And so I decided to do it, and it's been a lot of work, but it's been rewarding so far. The thing I love about Friday night is community. It's a chance for your entire area to come together, where you've got senior citizens who've been going to games for 50 years. You've got young kids who are out in the community and have a chance to get out and see their classmates in a non-school setting. You've got parents. It's a very social atmosphere. Everyone comes together to root on their team. And there are certain things I just love about Friday nights. My latest favorite has been watching these dance lines come out at halftime and bringing the little 5 and 6 year old and 7 year old girls with them. And it's the biggest thing in their life when they're out on the field. Some people are not looking, but I'm spending my time in halftime watching all these little girls trying to dance and be with the bigger girls, and how important it is to them on the Friday night lights to have their parents watching them. It's the biggest thing in their lives, and that's what makes football so great. It's one night, everybody comes together for the community to celebrate their area. I can't think of a better place to be on Friday night.
Neither can we. Thanks very much to Jim. Scores now. Perham wins 35-7. Hermantown over Duluth East. 42-6 was the final. Other scores. Kirkhoven, Murdoch, Sunberg beaten 20-14. Big upset. Dilworth in 3A over 4A Detroit Lakes. 21-0. Other scores. Waterville Elysian Falls 22-0. Fillmore Central in 1A. 40-0 over Lewiston Altura. Royalton shut out by St. Cloud Cathedral, and Pipestone over Laverne. 3-0 was the final. That's it for our show. We're back next Friday night with another edition of the Prep Sports Extra, and we hope to see you then. Have a good night.